affected, but I speak with a very with a very sober heart about the way the whole world is in crisis. Everybody's contribution is appreciated, but when the church brings our contribution, everybody rejects our contribution. The scientists are contributing. As I speak to you, some sportsmen are even deciding that they want to find a way of entertaining people even in their house. So they want to find a way of going to do some kind of entertainment or some kind of sports that will keep people comfortable. The bankers are playing their role. Nurses and doctors are playing their role. Everybody's playing their role. And community and everybody, they accept it. The church has a role to play. People frown on the effort of the church. They laugh at us. They mock us. They make us think what we are doing is useless. When we pray, they say, hey, stop the prayer. It will not be anything. We don't need it. When we say, well, two or three are gathered together, there am I in the midst of them. They also stop this nonsense. They just believe that everything we are doing is nothing. Peter said, silver and gold have I none, but such as I have, give I thee. I want to encourage a certain Christian under the sound of my voice to know that your prayer is important. Maybe it is more important than even money. Your prayer is important. Maybe it is even more important than any other thing you are doing. I believe in all the hygiene protocols and everything that we are doing. But ladies and gentlemen, all these things without prayer and without God will amount to nothing, except the Lord build a house, they labor in vain that build it. And except the Lord keep the city, the watchman worketh, but in vain. It is vain for you to rise up early and sit up late to eat the bread of sorrow, for so he giveth his beloved sleep. You know what, people? You can look at all the statistics. In the morning, you are looking on the statistics. In the afternoon, you are looking at them. In the night, you are looking at them, and so on and so forth. We don't sleep because we are just checking the progression of this particular infirmity. But except the Lord keep the city, the watchman wicked but in vain. I want to encourage you, believer, keep praying. Keep speaking the word. If the world does not believe in what we believe in it. When David took his stone to go and kill Goliath, Goliath looked at him and said, am I a dog that you are bringing a stone against me? But ladies and gentlemen, alas, it was a stone that killed him. Listen to me. Your prayer will kill a virus. Your prayer and the anointing of God on your life will slay the wicked and destroy the enemy. You know, the solutions the world is bringing, we embrace them. We accept them. When you come into this room right now where I'm speaking, everybody's wearing a nose mask apart from me because I can't speak through it. If I spoke through it right now, I may sound like a ghost speaking from a room. So I had to put it away so that I can do this broadcast. But everybody, about the five people I see in this room with me, separated, social distancing, they're wearing the mask. I'm very strict on them. But I also know that except the Lord keep the city, the watchman wicked, but in vain. The Bible said, having done all to stand. So you know what? The church and as believers, we believe in the solution that is coming from the experts. But what we are telling the world is that we too, this is what we can contribute. We can contribute prayer. We can contribute the word of God. We can contribute the anointing. We can also suggest repentance, that the world should repent of our sins. We can suggest that. We can preach that. And I'm praying that any believer under the sound of my voice be bold about the fact that God has also given you solution. The church cannot be quiet at this time. The church cannot be silent at this time. He said, call upon me. He said, don't be silent. He said, raise up your voice in prayer. He said, pray, cry unto me, go on your knees, pray. Pray, 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 pray. And you know what, people? Sometimes the fact that the world is rejecting our solution and they are rejecting who we are, the church of Jesus Christ, does not mean we too we should doubt it. No, no, no. Listen to me. A time may come when the unbelievers themselves will start begging us for prayer. Pray for us, pray for us. Today I was taking my vitamins and I was making a joke.